Hello, today we'll be talking about how the Cloud Security and Safety Platform Managed Methods can provide help with over 33% of the reasonable security practices defined by the Learning Technology Center of Illinois to comply with the new SOPA law. These areas will be focused on the Google Workspace or Microsoft 365 environments you might have. These are security practices that are important as you begin to work to comply with the new SOPA law. We'll start on the Apps tab, which can help with software assets and emails and browsers. Our third-party applications will provide insight into what third-party applications your end users have granted access via an OAuth token. With software assets, managed methods can help with maintaining an inventory of authorized applications. Managed methods can help you maintain a list of approved applications connected to your Google Workspace or Microsoft 365 environment. This would be through the ability to provide visibility into those specific applications, and then the ability to create an approved list of applications using our sanction functionality here to go ahead and sanction those applications that you know and trust and are part of that approved list. You'll then be able to easily go ahead and filter or sort by those applications which you've gone ahead and sanctioned and the ones you haven't, and also be able to run specific reports to show you which specific applications have been sanctioned by the district by quickly applying a filter here and then running a report here at the top, either downloading it as a PDF or downloading it as a CSV. In conjunction with this too, we can go ahead and actually revoke access to those applications which are unapproved and which you weren't aware existed in the first place. And this can help with the second part of addressing unapproved software. So we'll show you all these third-party applications regardless of the device, and you'll be able to see specifically what they have access to under the scope categories, as well as the specific users that have gone ahead and connected any one application in question here. From here, you can either set policies or take one-off actions to go ahead and break those specific permissions to those applications, ensuring that you know exactly what applications have access and are all part of your specific approved list. The last component will be making sure that you have only fully supported browsers and email clients. This will primarily be on the email side of things, ensuring any of those third-party email management services are ones that you know and trust or are specifically authorized. And those will always be found here under the access, under access levels and view and manage emails, where you could see if there were any specific applications that may fall under that category and might be one of those unapproved email clients that you weren't aware anyone was even utilizing. And again, you'll be able to quickly revoke access to it to break those permissions or set up specific policies to continually break those permissions to that one application in question. For reasonable security practices in regard to malware, managed methods can look for potential malware in Drive files, OneDrive files, ShareDrive files, SharePoint Teams files, and email attachments of both Gmail and Outlook. This will go beyond simply ensuring malware for removal to devices is covered, and will look for potential other vectors of malware which could cause serious problems. In our malware tab here itself, we'll define malware as suspicious and malicious, and we leverage Cylance to our malware scanning. Malware that's considered malicious can automatically be deleted or quarantined through policies, and you can always go ahead and examine specific malware files in here to get specific scan results and take a look at why something was flagged as malware and take direct action to either delete or quarantine that malware in question. To help with maintaining an inventory of sensitive information, managed methods can provide scans for sensitive information and the creation of policies to automatically mitigate potential issues such as oversharing with sensitive information such as social security numbers, credit card numbers, FERPA, and IEP information. You can create policies to alert about specific ways sensitive information may be being sent or shared outside of the district, and there will also be the ability to go through and audit specific incidents that have happened, and even revoke specific sharing permission, or even deleting specific files that contain sensitive information that people no longer need to have access to. This can help address maintaining the inventory of sensitive information, and also remove that sensitive information which is not being regularly accessed by district personnel. As you can see here, we've got a number of risk scans that will look for that potential sensitive information. We have PII here, which will look for social security numbers, PCI, which will look for credit card numbers, FERPA, which will be looking for potential FERPA violations, and IEP, which will be looking for potential IEP violations. If we come over to our policies section here, we can actually have policies configured to specifically alert us about ways specific sensitive information is being transmitted. In this case, we can see this is looking for Drive files, emails, or share drive that are being explicitly shared to the outside that contain any kind of credit card number or social security number. And from here, I can take specific action, whether that be to delete the files, revoke the specific shares, or even just warn the end users about the specific actions in question. If we need to do some further digging, I can also quickly look for potential policy violations and quickly go ahead and find the specific incidents in question, hop over to the information in question, and do some further digging and quickly identify exactly what's happened with this specific incident, and even take a specific deeper dive into the file itself, all the way back up to 6 months here, to get basic information about what's happened with the file and who's actually had access to it. So that's how we'll help with some components of maintaining an inventory of that sensitive information. Another component that managed methods can help with is training to make sure that your end users know specifically how they're sharing sensitive information and preventing it from accidentally being shared, or ensuring that you know exactly how information is being transmitted. For example, if I go ahead and take a look at how this social security information is being looked at, I can quickly apply filters here to figure out exactly how this information is being transmitted. So I can look for emails that have been sent to the outside that contain potential social security numbers, or I can even look for potential social security numbers that are in files being sent to the outside as well. This can be helpful as a training exercise, or to specifically set up policies to go ahead and warn your specific users about specific actions they may be taking, to go ahead and train them and get them better prepared to handle sensitive information and ensure that they're not accidentally sharing or leaking sensitive information that they shouldn't be. With the Manage Methods Accounts tab, there'll be a number of things that can help you comply with the reasonable security practices. The first will be able to help you with any unassociated accounts that you'll be able to suspend or change the passwords to, and ensuring that those accounts are either no longer active or are secure. And those will be found with the various buttons here to either suspend the account or change the password, or by clicking into the account specifically. Also, through the Accounts tab on the Manage Methods page, you'll be able to go ahead and take a look at specific audit logs. Here, if we go ahead and click into Download Audit Activity, we'll be able to see a number of activity types, including things like Calendar, Drive, Login, OAuth Token, Mobile, and even User Accounts here. These reports can be run up to 6 months to provide you some good insight into exactly what's going on within your Google Workspace environment. You'll also be able to audit specific Meet activity as well, and that can also be downloaded here through the Download Audit Activity button. And these reports can also be run on an individual account as well. Diving into a specific individual account, you can go ahead and take a look at specific login activity and ensure that correct two-step verification logins have been enabled and how many of those have happened, and ensure that the end user is logging in from the correct locations to ensure that that account is fully under that user's control. On our Gmail or Outlook tabs, you'll be able to quickly take a look and see what kinds of potential phishing emails may have been detected by the platform. We utilize both Google Web Risk API as well as PhishTank to look for potential phishing emails that are coming in, and then you'll be able to set specific policies to alert staff, or even have the specific phishing emails be trashed automatically, or even be specifically deleted. And you'll be able to specifically examine why something was flagged as phishing with specific URLs, and where the specific phishing email ended up in that specific user's inbox. This can be very helpful to help mitigate some of those potential issues around phishing that's very, very common to see. To help you identify and report about specific incidents, and also help train your staff, on both the Microsoft 365 and Google Workspace environments, we can create policies here to have the platform alert you about specific incidents, whether that be sensitive information being transmitted to outside the district, malware coming in through Drive files, email, or Share Drive in this case, or whatever specific incident you want to be alerted about. You'll be able to create specific policies, either to just alert you about the specific incident in question, or actually send out specific warning messages to help train end users and get them better prepared to handle sensitive information or deal with other specific issues that might have happened. We also have our Policy Violations tab, which will be a running log of the specific incidents which have happened, and this can be a very helpful way to quickly identify those incidents which have happened and take a look at the specific issue at hand. I hope this look at some of the areas of the Manage Methods platform will help you identify some areas where you can quickly comply with SOPA laws utilizing our platform. I encourage you to learn more about Manage Methods and take a closer look at exactly how we can help you with these specific areas. Thanks for your time.